Mr. Montemayor, the NFA, of course, is saying it will not affect the procurement price. Don't you trust that statement?
Well, the problem is, Stanley, is that as hard as NFA is trying to procure palay, more palay, it, because of its limited funding, the at most it can just procure about 2% of production. In order to have a real influence on the prices of palay, whether NFA or not, you have to procure at least 10% of marketable surplus. So, salamat sa NFA na they are doing their best to buy more palay, but they will not be able to buy the palay of 98% of our farmers.
Okay, so there are issues there as far as, you know, if the National Food Authority can, of course, sustain this kind of scheme. Now, when you talk about timing, Mr. Montemayor, we're entering the La Nina phase where agricultural losses are expected due to bad weather conditions. Now, how is this brewing the perfect storm, if you will, for local farmers now?
Well, this is compounded. This likelihood again of La Nina happening on the heels of El Nino, this tariff cut that was decided upon recently by the NEDA board will be a man-made calamity, if I can call it that, because it will invite more imports to come in. And leading to what I mentioned earlier, to the likelihood of lower prices of palay. So matatama ng farmers natin ng natural na kalamidad, eh sasabayan pa ng man-made calamity.
Okay, Mr. Montemayor, you know, in hindsight, what should have been considered before any cut in imported tariffs was made? I mean, government, of course, is justifying this as a means to improve food supply in the country in the next couple of months. But is this the only way?
Yeah, it's not the only way, Stanley, and in fact, it's the wrong way, because experience shows us during the past 4 years, when the tariffs on rice imported from non-ASEAN countries were lowered, but the tariff cut did not redound to the benefit of consumers in terms of lower prices at retail. The same thing has happened in the case of lower tariffs under Executive Order Number 50 and its previous versions with respect to importation of pork, corn, and chicken. Binaba po yung taripa sa mga produkto ito, kasama po yung bigas, pero hindi po nakinabang ang ating consuming public. Ang maliwanag pong nakinabang ay yung pong ating mga importers at saka traders.
All right. Lastly, Mr. Montemayor, are you seeing, you know, a predictable failure again in terms of government approach in this decision?
Yes, we see that happening again, Stanley. And, you know, down the road, it sends these tariff cuts will send a very wrong signal to our producers that they cannot rely on government protection in terms of tariff cover. And therefore, if as a result of that, the prices of palay will drop, then we can see even, you know, more imports later and less production as far as local production is concerned.
All right. On that note, thank you so much for your insights, Mr. Leonardo Montemayor, Board Chairman of Federation of Free Farmers in the Philippines. Thanks a lot for joining us.
Thank you also. Thank you.
Have a great day.